My name is Melanie, and I'm here to do a land acknowledgement before we start our program. We acknowledge the land because it's important to know where we are and who we share space with. Are you ready? Haudenosaunee, Mississauga, and Anishinaabe nations came together with all their relations. Living together, they had a united wish to share the land and waters in peace, like one spoon with a dish. Now many Indigenous families, Métis and Inuit too, live here in treaty agreement with me and you. In the spirit of peace, friendship, and mutual respect, we protect each other and the land, which we should never forget. Thank you, friends. Enjoy your program.
Hi, everyone. My name is Lynn from Toronto Public Library, and welcome to Summer Wonder at Home. Today, we're going to explore the world of design by focusing on playgrounds. So let's get started. Playgrounds can be found all over and are built for so many different reasons. Maybe you've seen a small playground meant for babies and toddlers with sand and swings and low slides. Or maybe you've been to a bigger playground that has like monkey bars and climbing ropes and big kid swings, or even a wading pool. Perhaps you've seen a big play structure like a castle or a ship, or you've seen playgrounds for adults with workout equipment. I know I've seen kids playing on that too. Hopefully over the summer, you've had a chance to visit some of the many playgrounds that your neighborhood and city have to offer. So today, let's make our own dream playground. Now before we build it, we need to plan it out. Now I like to use paper and a pencil with my handy eraser when I start out so that I can make changes easily, since once I start thinking, new ideas tend to pop up in my mind all the time. So I keep my eraser handy. Now, if you prefer, you can use a crayon, you can use a pen, or maybe you've got a drawing tool on your computer. Whatever works best for you. Now I think about my W's. Who, what, where, and when. These are all important questions for you to think about when you're designing and making your playground. So, who is this playground for? Are you aiming for kids, babies, adults? Or maybe you want a playground for your pet? Or maybe even your neighborhood squirrel? Now, you want to give this some thought, because a playground for a kid is going to be way different from a playground for a squirrel. Just saying. And think about people with different abilities. Let's say you're building a park for kids. Can you make it so that kids who are in wheelchairs can play too? Maybe adding braille or touch components for kids who are sight impaired. Or maybe you want to have kids who are autistic use your playground. And you want to make sure that your colors are soothing and that you use building materials that don't make too much noise. Or maybe you're going to offer ear protectors to kids who want them. All of these things need to be thought about. So give this planning part some time and think through the needs of the people or animals you are designing the playground for. Next, I think about what. What kind of playground? Are you thinking water park, maybe climbing rope, or just a giant ball pit? Or do you want to build it like a giant obstacle course with like jumping off points, or maybe just trampolines? You are only limited by your imagination. Now, where? This can be tricky. Are you thinking this playground is going to be in your backyard? Maybe the local park or the beach? Or who says it even needs to be here on Earth? Maybe you want to design the first playground on Mars. We know that people are planning to visit there. Kids will follow eventually, and they're going to want to play, right? Or maybe you think that octopus and fish and sharks would like a playground. Maybe like a sunken ship or something. That would be cool. You have to think, if this is in my backyard, I can head inside when I'm thirsty or if I need the bathroom. But what if I'm at the beach? Do I need some shade too? You need to think about bathrooms. You need to think about trees and benches so you can chill for a bit while you're having a snack. All things to consider when you're thinking about the where. When. Now, when is easier, since I'm guessing you're going to want to play on your playground as soon as possible. But maybe you're thinking an ice playground would be perfect. Well, you can't make an ice playground here in August. You're going to have to wait till maybe December or January till we get lots of snow and ice. Or maybe you want to make a playground for crabs that you found this summer at the beach. But you and your family, you're not going back to the beach for a while. That is awesome too. Maybe you want to imagine building a playground. What about for dinosaurs? I mean, why not? You can make a playground for not just any place, but any time in space. Just because you come up with a great plan doesn't mean you can always do that plan right away. Sometimes you need to be patient and wait. But that just gives you more time to think, plan, and imagine. Now, once I have my playground design, I'm going to look around to see what I have to build to make up my model with. You can use whatever you find around the house. So I've got some Lego. I have some plasticine. I've got some string. You know, I can come up with whatever I want. But I have to remember, you're going to want to check with a grown-up before you start this portion of the challenge. And then maybe some of you don't even want to build anything. You just want to stick with drawing. So draw it again without the eraser markers. And this time I did mine in black pen. There you go. So there's my dog park. And look, I've got trees. I have benches, garbage cans, a pool. I even have a hill for them to run up and down. All right, now, we would love to see what you make. So ask an adult to take a picture of your design and share it with the Toronto Public Library on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. They can use the hashtag #TPLSummerWonder. We can't wait to see what you're going to come up with. I hope you enjoyed today's creativity challenge. Check back soon for more from Toronto Public Library Summer Wonder programs. Bye for now.